Hi, I'm Joachim for Statistics Globe, and in this video I'll explain how to subset a data frame based on a factor column using the R programming language. In the video I'm going to show you two examples, and both of these examples are based on the data frame that we can create with lines 2 to 4 of the code. So if you run these lines of code, you can see at the top right of RStudio that a new data frame object is appearing, and if you click on this data set, a new window is opened which is showing the structure of our data frame. And as you can see, our data contains 6 rows and 2 columns, which are called x1 and x2. And the first column of our data frame contains different factor levels, and the second column contains numeric values. Now let's assume that we want to subset this data frame based on the factor column x1. Then we can apply the code that you can see in line 6. And in this line of code, I'm specifying the name of our data set. Then I'm opening square brackets, and within the square brackets I'm specifying a logical condition based on our factor column x1. So in this case I'm telling R that I want to keep only those rows where the values or the factor levels in the column x1 are equal to A. And then I'm closing the square brackets to finish this line of code, and I'm storing the output of this in a new data set which is called data new 1. So if you run line 6 of the code, you can see that a new data frame object appears at the top right, which is called data new 1. And we can have a look at this data set by clicking on the data object, and then you can see that we have returned only 2 rows of our original input data set, and those 2 rows both contain the factor level A in our factor column x1. So in this first example, I have explained how to return only those rows of a data frame where a factor column has a certain level. However, it is also possible to return rows based on multiple factor levels. And this is what I want to show you in line 8 of the code. So in this line of code, I'm using again the factor column x1. Then I'm specifying the in operator, and then I'm specifying a vector of factor levels containing those factor levels that I want to keep in our data set. And then I'm storing the output of this in a new data frame object, which is called data new 2. So if you run line 8 of the code, another data object is appearing at the top right, which is called data new 2. And if you click on this data object, you can see that we have created another data frame subset. And this time we have kept all rows where the column x1 contained the factor level A or D. So in this video I have explained how to subset a data frame based on a factor column using the R programming language. However, in case you want to learn more on this topic, you could check out my homepage, statisticsglobe.com, because on my homepage I have recently published a tutorial in which I'm explaining the content of this video in some more detail, and I will put a link to this tutorial into the description of this video so you can check it out there. Furthermore, if you have liked the video, I would be very happy if you leave me some positive feedback in the comments, and make sure to subscribe to my YouTube channel to get notifications in future when I'm releasing new videos to the channel. That's it for this video. Thanks a lot. See you in the next video.